First Defense Weather, the Southern Tier's only live and local weather source. Now, here's Chief Forecaster Dakota Hunter.
And welcome back. And that Powerball is not coming out of the weather staff's budget either. Storm spotter training once again comes up next Monday the 25th at WCA Hospital at 7:30. And if you can't make it, do not worry. The Weather Service is also doing online spotter training on May 2nd. Now for the online, you do need to register. And this is the link where you can go to register. Once again, I'll throw this out on the web and of course on social media as well. And again, we need more storm spotters. It's only spotters that see down at the ground and we need more of them. So I encourage you to attend. Now, I showed this graphic yesterday. Yesterday was the spring equinox or the vernal equinox, the official first day of spring. Today's the first full day of spring. And essentially, the spring equinox is when the sun is directly above the equator and the days are equal. So we have 12 hours of daylight and 12 hours of nighttime. Although in the U.S., we have a little bit more than 12 hours of daylight, but it's around equal across the entire globe. News now, Cam, not as sunny as it was yesterday. We have a lot of clouds around and a few dropping. 41 degrees is the current temp with that south wind to 9. Again, as long as we have a southerly wind component, that will continue to keep us a little bit mild, and the wind chill is down to 35 degrees. But it's not as warm as it was yesterday, and not a whole lot of sun to go around for today either. This is the next storm system. It's currently down here in Virginia, down here. This is the storm system that's going to ride across the Northeast. And you can see a few of those rain showers across Western New York. As we zoom right into it, you can see here we've had a few of these scattered rain showers. And again, this isn't going to be steady state. It's not going to be anything heavy, but there will be a few raindrops to go through this afternoon. Now, looking past this, that storm system is going to ride right along the East Coast. And this is ultimately going to bring us some snow tomorrow and Saturday. So here's your first defense on everything we know. So the storm system will ride along the Northeast. What's going to happen is as the storm system moves across the East Coast, it's going to drag in colder Canadian air and it will wrap around the back edge of this system. Highs on Friday only into the lower 30s, and the same thing on Saturday. That's February type cold, and we are expecting several inches of fresh accumulation. So we'll show this to you here on FutureScan. You can see the storm system here. Watch it work across the East Coast. It's mainly going to be rain across the East Coast because this is where the warmer air is. But peek back here, you can see on the back edge, you can see that colder air wrapping right in, and that's going to trigger off these snow showers throughout the day on Friday, and also the same thing on Saturday, ultimately ending Saturday night going into Sunday. So snow accumulations, this is what we're going with in terms of overall accumulations, about 2 to 4 inches. It's not anything major, but still, it's springtime snow. So again, I think this will be at least a little bit shovelable. But again, 2 to 4 inches on average. Obviously, once you work out here towards the Tug Hill, that's where the heavier amounts of the snow will be. Here comes the future. It's powered by Brotherhood Property Maintenance. And again, look at that, 30s over the next couple of days and snow, 2 to 4 inches Friday. And hey, we get one more day of 50s with sunshine on Sunday. Temperatures go back into the 30s before they warm back up again with more sunshine on Wednesday.